In recent years, a number of culinary luminaries have passed away without their deaths being widely recorded. Here are some food celebrities you might not realize were dead, but whose work you likely appreciated while they lived. Whether by watching them on TV, reading their critical writing, or tasting foods influenced by their touch. Narayana Reddy was better known to the world, and in particular to his native India, as Grandpa Kitchen. In just 2 short years, his YouTube channel brought the septuagenarian chef a degree of fame and accolades. Not only because the massive meals he cooked outdoors over open flames looked delicious, but because the food Grandpa Kitchen prepared was served almost exclusively to orphaned children and others in need. He used almost all the proceeds his YouTube videos created to donate funds to charities as well. Reddy had a warm and loving demeanor and started off each of his videos.
Hello guys, how are you? Welcome to our channel. This is your grandpa.
And while the volume of food he prepared made replicating the recipes exactly all but impossible for most chefs, his videos were a joy to watch simply for their own merit. Grandpa Reddy died in the fall of 2019. But younger members of his family have continued this kind man's work, and the introduction to every video still features Grandpa Reddy greeting viewers before the younger generation takes over. They continue to cook and feed the hungry in India and have a YouTube channel currently boasting more than 8.3 million subscribers. Known as much for his spiked-up mane of hair as his successful restaurants, TV show hosting roles and appearances, and his competitive cooking on programs like Hell's Kitchen and MasterChef, the death of Gary Rhodes in late November of 2019 was an absolute shock to the culinary world. The apparently healthy 59-year-old chef died within hours of collapsing suddenly at his home. The cause was later revealed to be an internal brain bleed known as a subdural hematoma. Rhodes had shown no signs of health issues leading up to the sudden collapse. His passing brought mournful remembrances from luminaries in the food world, including Jamie Oliver and Gordon Ramsay, among many others. Rhodes had a long and storied career. He ran a Michelin-star restaurant at age 26 before going on to open successful restaurants in both London and Dubai. He had his own line of bread mixes and cooking tools. On top of all of that, Rhodes was knighted in 2006. Floyd Cardoz is so far the highest-profile food celebrity whose death is attributed to complications associated with the COVID-19 coronavirus. Cardoz died in a New Jersey hospital in March of 2020, not long after returning from his native India. Cardoz was a pioneering chef who was largely responsible for opening the American palate up to Indian cuisine, now one of the most popular ethnic cuisines in the country. He polished his craft with studies at the renowned Swiss culinary school Le Roche, before coming to the United States, where he would run several successful restaurants in New York City and go on to open 2 new restaurants himself. He also opened several restaurants in Mumbai, authored 2 cookbooks, and appeared on a myriad of popular cooking shows, including Top Chef Masters. Cardoz was also celebrated for the charitable work to which he devoted much of his time and energy. One of the last posts on Cardoz's Instagram account is a tribute to Chef Gray Coons, who had passed away not long before. Sadly, the last post on the account would come just days later on March 11th, shortly before Cardoz fell seriously ill. Jonathan Gold was to the Los Angeles food scene what Vin Scully was to Los Angeles sports. Gold primarily wrote for the Los Angeles Times, where he covered the ever-developing LA restaurant scene, a scene many in the food world felt had come to rival that of New York, London, or Paris in recent years. Gold won a Pulitzer Prize for his food writing with LA Weekly in 2007 and came close again in 2011, and was considered one of the finest critics working when he died at age 57 after a short fight with a virulent case of pancreatic cancer. In his later years, Gold cut a distinctive figure with long hair ringing a balding crown with a thick mustache. He was also known for his easy smile and affable demeanor. The celebrated food writer started his journalistic career writing about music, including the then-nascent rap scene. No surprise, then, that much of his food writing focused on street food, mom-and-pop restaurants, and emerging trends, a break from most food criticism at the time that focused more on high-end dining. Aaron Grissom had so much potential left to give when he died following a motorcycle accident at just 34 years old. The young chef had hit a troubled spell after a domestic violence arrest in 2014, but he was on an ascendant path again, having left Los Angeles for Tacoma, where he found work at a local restaurant and began carving out a name as a chef for the stars. Grissom cooked for a myriad of A-list celebrities when they visited his home state, Washington, and looked poised to carve out a meaningful career in that capacity. Before the stint cooking in LA, he had appeared on TV programs like Top Chef and Diners, Drive-Ins and Dives. His competitive and often prickly attitude did not always win Grissom the warmth of viewers or of his fellow competitors, but he was clearly a talented chef and had a knack for celebrity. Grissom was wearing a helmet when he lost control of his bike. The crash was not a result of recklessness or intoxication. Adrian Anthony Gill, better known as A.A. Gill, his usual pen name, died as he lived, both irreverently and with class.
Oh my God, just happens to be here. A book written by me.
His acerbic criticism was seen as overly harsh and crass by some readers, as hilarious and informative by many more. He published multiple books, many of which were travelogues anchored by food-related content, a few of which were novels that were largely panned by literary critics, and he wrote for major publications like Britain's Sunday Times. An alcoholic in early life, he chose the AA sobriquet in homage to the Alcoholics Anonymous program that helped him overcome his drinking. He also wrote openly about his struggles with addiction and overcoming it. His clear-eyed and honest discussion of his troubles endeared him to many readers. Gill announced that he was suffering from an embarrassment of, quote, the full English, of metastasized cancer in late November of 2016 and died within a few short weeks. Cristie Schoen Codd's death at age 38 was absolutely devastating to her family and friends, and to many fans who had watched the chef's ascendance. The devastation was three-part, as Codd was killed along with her husband and their unborn child. The suspected killer was a man named Robert Owens, who had done work at the Codd's home. A fiery competitor on the Food Network series Food Network Star, Codd was primarily interested in Cajun cooking and was frequently hired to be the caterer and chef for major Hollywood movie productions, including the films Ender's Game, Dawn of the Planet of the Apes, and Terminator Genesis. Her passing drew a sorrowful tweet from the latter film star, former California Governor Arnold Schwarzenegger, who said Cristie, quote, brought us together at meals like a family. She and her husband had met through the film industry in which Joseph Codd had worked as a key grip. Josh Ozersky left an oversized mark on the food world for a man who died at age 47. He wrote for Time and Esquire. He created New York Magazine's influential column Grub Street. He penned successful books like Restaurant Guide, Meet Me in Manhattan, and the social history book The Hamburger, A History. Ozersky's work served to elevate common food, such as the burger, as well as to make seemingly highfalutin foods more accessible to all eaters. He was the founder of Meatopia, an event that began as a one-off party in New York, grew into a ticketed event 2 years later, and soon grew into annual festivals held in multiple cities around the world. His death in 2015 was a shock and was caused by a freak accident. After suffering a seizure while in a hotel shower, Ozersky collapsed to the ground and subsequently drowned while unconscious. He was visiting Chicago on the occasion of the annual Beard Awards at the time of his untimely death. To call Homaro Cantu a chef would be like calling Leonardo da Vinci a painter. Cantu was indeed a chef, but also an inventor, designer, scientist, businessman, and philanthropist.
Do you see yourself as part of a genre or a school or a group?
I like to think of it as culinary terrorism.
But it was a blend of scientific and artful work with food that made the young man famous and wealthy. His restaurant Moto had earned a Michelin star when Cantu was little past 35 years old. He was a true pioneer and innovator of molecular gastronomy, creating things like carbonated fruit, edible menus and utensils, and edible smoldering cigars that were in fact pork shoulder wrapped in collard greens. The holder of myriad patents, Cantu seemed to have no end to ideas about not only what foods to work with, but also how to cook them. He was always eco-conscious and looking out for the disadvantaged as well, as he did when designing an oven that cooked using minimal power such that it might be usable by people in areas without reliable access to electricity. Cantu reportedly slept no more than 4 hours per night and was constantly reading or tinkering in the kitchen or garage when not working. His death by hanging in 2015 came as a shock to his family, friends, and those in the culinary world. If you or anyone you know is having suicidal thoughts, please call or chat online with the National Suicide Prevention Lifeline at 1-800-273-TALK-8255.